Yo, YouTube, it's Anarchist of Darkness, also known as Sir Killington of Colorstruck, and I'm about to do a WWE Black mixed with a Sir Killington of Colorstruck. How often do I get a chance to really mix it up a little bit with racial politics and a WWE in real life situations? Not often, but I got a chance now. Thank you, Xavier Woods. Now, if you don't know who Xavier Woods is, he is the third member of the New Day. He's the one who plays the trombone on the WWE. He, go look him up, Twitter, at Xavier Woods, PhD. Yes, this is a smart brother, right? He is doing it big in the world of wrestling, and I wish him the best. Now, before I get to this, let me explain to you guys. So, something happened between him and Alex Thomas. Alex Thomas is a comedian. He has a little bit of a following, and this guy, Alex Thomas, saw the Bootios advertisement in Annapolis Mall, right? He saw this and he felt a certain way about it, and he Instagrammed about it, and it got to Xavier Woods. Xavier Woods wrote a long ass diatribe, explaining something to Alex Thomas, and I want to read it, but I don't want to read it. I might read some parts from it. Guys, this is going to be a long fucking video. Bear with me, okay? It's going to be maybe 15 minutes because I love this so fucking much. I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. So, Xavier Woods responded to Alex Thomas. Now, let's get one thing straight before. I'm not going to take anybody's side because I would be partial and biased for Xavier Woods. But because I understand the social science of why Alex Thomas wrote what he did, I'm going to remain as unbiased as I possibly can. But when faults are faults, faults will be faults. I know that don't make any sense, right? When unknowns mean unknowns, like not. Nah. Okay, so, guys, if you don't know who Xavier Woods is, I already explained it. So, but this is his response to the guy, right? Here he goes. Someone sent me your post, Funny Man, at Funny Man Alex Thomas. I assume so that I could clear up the disgusting assumptions that you made of me and my group, The New Day. What we are doing with our current position in the is the furthest thing from racism, but I can see that you did not feel the need to figure out the why or the how before making an attempt to inflame your following or attempt to inflame your following to get a few extra likes for your IG. Now let me stop right there. Xavier, while I love you, that is unfair. It is totally unfair, right? I get where you're coming from. He should have done research. But Xavier, you're smart enough to understand that older African Americans, obviously Alex Thomas is about 35, 40 years old, older African Americans lived in a different time, right? So they see things differently. Older African Americans remember when Aunt Jemima looked like a Sambo and not like my foster mother. My foster mother hates it. I always say she looks like the Aunt Jemima box, but she remembers the old Aunt Jemima. She hates it when I say that. Okay? She remembers Sambo. A lot of the older ones who are 40 years old, they remember Sambo. And I'm sorry, I love the New Day. I've been their biggest supporter since day one. Even when you guys was Spirit Squad meets church choir preacher. I fucking hated that gimmick because it was racist as fuck. That shit was fucking racist, right? And it's funny because you even mentioned it in this, and I love you for that even more. But let me continue, right? You have to, like I was saying, you have to remember this guy probably grew up in a different time. So when he saw it, he felt a certain way. He probably wasn't trying to inflame nobody. Yes, he tagged in the NAACP, but psh, let's be real. Some of the older black people who don't know who the New Day is, they may walk by that and see, oh fucking shit. They got Sambos out here. And unfortunately, when I see it, because I know my history, I still see that. Unfortunately, I still see the Sambos, but I get where it comes from because I'm a wrestling fan. All right, let's continue. All right, my brothers and I have done everything possible in our power to change the perspective of the way African Americans have been viewed in the past by our industry, professional wrestling. There was a time where being black meant that you were either foreign, a dancer, or simply a big black strong guy. Think about that. Let's stop and think. Xavier Woods came in. He was a dancer. Kofi Kingston came in. He was a foreign. He was foreign. He was SOS. I hear them call it. He was the Jamaican. And Big E Langston was a bodyguard. Big, black, and strong. Did you just see that? If I'm not the... It's funny because when I do these videos, a lot of people are like, oh, you're seeing something that's not there. Okay. Okay. Anyway, Xavier Woods sees it, and he's in the WWE. Anyway, let's continue. There was a time where being black meant... Okay, I already did that. We used to be classified by the color of our skin and typecast in these roles without being given a clean slate to be whatever it is that we wanted to be. Let's continue. This is the next part. Which means that the idea of starting with a clean slate is something that we have to face from both ends. Right? For example, as I stated, the industry of professional wrestling viewed us black people in a certain manner due to our skin color. And then you, a black comedian with a solid following and a voice, sees one of our products, types, lies about it, says we are cooning, and hashtags blackface without feeling the need to do any type of research on why or how that has come into existence. Now, like I said before, Xavier is absolutely right. Alex Thomas is too old, has too much of a following to not, you know what, I'm going to research this before I get really pissed off about it, right? Because what happens is you make a statement and your followers see it and your followers follow behind you and they get all riled up about it. That is true. But Xavier Woods, like I said before, you can't blame the man. He grew up probably in a different time, I'm almost positive. He's like 35 plus years old, where he probably remembers Coon Aunt Jemima, Sambo Aunt Jemima. So we're both wrong here, because I doubt Alex was trying to somehow start a ruckus with the Bootios thing. I'm sure if he was trying to do it, it was because he felt a certain way about it. It's not because he felt ill towards Xavier Woods. And it is his fault he didn't do anything. He didn't say anything. Wait, what is this? Somebody explain this to me. He could have easily have done that, but he didn't do it. He's wrong there. But Xavier Woods, you're old enough, you're smart enough to understand that when some of us black people see that box, they still see Sambo. I saw Bamboozle. Because I saw Bamboozle, whenever I see a black character with really dark black skin, big white eyes, I see Sambo, unfortunately. Thank God they don't got the red lips on there, and that would be over the top, but I still see it. I'm saying this as a New Day fan. I'm saying this as a black man who's a New Day fan who loves professional wrestling but also understands the historical context to certain things. And I thank Xavier Woods and the New Day for helping trying to change all of this. I thank them for it because it changes, because these little kids... Sambo stuff is so far away. They'll eventually learn about it, but these little kids who are coming up now, they'll see black men on a cereal box and not necessarily see and think about Sambo. But when I was growing up, you saw a black cartoon, it was Sambo. And I'm your age. I am 28 years old. So I remember Sambo, and I'm pretty sure you remember Sambo too. So you remember, historical context, he felt a certain way, he said something about it. But Xavier Woods is absolutely right in this context, except just, I doubt this guy was trying to put a boot in your ass. It's just, he felt a certain way about it. He has every right to feel that way because of our historical context. Let's continue. All right. In the entertainment industry, we see blacks typecast in villainous light, playing gangsters, thugs, blah, etc., etc. What I've been saying on this channel forever. But luckily, it's getting better, which is true. What have I been saying on this channel? We wanted to do our part and help change that, so we did. We took an idea that was given to us to be overly charismatic, positive preachers, essentially another stereotype, cooning, which would have done nothing to help advance African Americans in our field. Xavier Woods, I love you, brother. I love you so much. No homo. Yeah. Anyway. I really do, because everything he's saying, I've been saying on this channel forever, especially when it comes to the New Day or anything. Everything he's saying, I've been saying. I got reference now, baby. I don't have to argue with these guys who come on and say, you're just racist. No, I'm just telling the truth. I live a certain way that you don't because I'm a black man in America, but you don't see it because you are not black. Anyway, let's continue. All right. Eventually, we spun the idea into something where we could simply be ourselves. My partners, Kofi Kingston and Big E, both have their college degrees. I myself have two degrees, a master and a nerd culture YouTube channel that helps to empower kids with similar interests rather than bringing them down for enjoying things that aren't in the mainstream. Thank you, Xavier Woods, and I can't wait till you get your PhD, because when we call you Dr. Woods or Dr. Creed, that would be hilarious. Not just hilarious, but it will be empowering for little black kids and even me, even though we're almost the same age. Let me continue. I'm a wrestler, okay? I want to go back to college. I already got a college degree in media arts and animation. I would like to get a college degree in sociology and I probably education, just bachelor's degrees. I don't want to go any further than that because I don't really like school that much. Let me continue. Blah, 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 myself. We expressed the idea that knowledge is power and that you can be literally whatever it is you want to be. The three of us were clowned growing up because of our interest in video games, comic books. Growing up, we weren't ever black enough for a lot of people. Let's stop there. I did a video not too long ago about that, about this whole you're not black enough or you're too white. It's blue on that whole bullshit. I fucking hate that. Thank you, Xavier Woods. It's funny. My wife last night said this to me. She said, how did I marry all three members of the New Day? Because if you know me, you would understand that. But I'm very silly with my wife. And she, honestly, she didn't like wrestling, but she loves the New Day just like I love the New Day. So let's continue. It's like, if you're black, you have probably heard of the saying, carefree black kids. And if you look at New Day is carefree black men, essentially, in the WWE. And it helps, let me continue, because he even says it in the video. It helps with the idea about black people. No, not the video, he says it in the thing. Let me continue. The three of us clown. Growing up, we weren't black enough. But when really looking at it, they meant that we didn't fall into the black stereotypes that we as black people hate being classified into. This does nothing but internally tear us down as a race where we're supposed to be building each other up. The acrament that we have unicorn horns and a trombone have stories and reasons that we come to the ring with them. It all has been a part of our evolution. Let me continue. This era was our idea and we love cartoons, so adding them into the mix was something that we definitely wanted to do. The way that we look on a cereal box is how we actually look, which is true. And that's where the guy got a little upset, because it's three black guys with big white eyes and dark skin and almost looks coonish. Let's be real, it almost looks coonish. And it's unfortunately, like I said, because of historical context. Okay, it ain't racist, but it does look Sambo. When some people who knows about Sambo, like little kids don't know what Sambo is. Okay, it's going to be some years before they learn about Sambo in school. But somebody like me who learned about Sambo early, who saw the movie, who also saw the movie Bamboozle, who know what Sambo is and what it was used for to dehumanize black people. When you see it, you see, oh, that's fucked up. But I also know, like I said before, I know the context, so I'm not offended by it. But Alex Thomas probably didn't know. Let me continue. I'm saying the same shit over and over again. I'm not taking up for anybody. But anyway, to say that we are cooning is extremely disrespectful to us, what we have accomplished, and what we are currently trying to do. We broke a record for the longest reigning tag team champions that had been intact for 20 years. We have changed the way that black people approach stereotypes about black people in our industry for the better. We are empowering not just black children, but all children to understand that you don't have to fit the mold or be what other people see you as in order to be successful. We have inspired people and helped them get through loss and depression. We participate in anti-bullying rallies. We meet amazing kids who are a part of a Make-A-Wish Foundation. We are on the road 300 days a year in order to bring joy and happiness to families across the world. Thank you, Xavier Woods, for that very touching and charming response to at Funny Man Alex Jones, or Alex Thomas. I'll keep saying Alex Jones. I don't know why I say Alex Jones. But to round off this video, Xavier Woods is absolutely correct. Now, when Xavier Woods is trying to get at him, saying, you're trying to do this, I doubt the man is trying to do anything. He saw something, it sparked something in him, and he went at it, okay? When I see something that I think is racist, I honestly will go at that shit. I still think the fucking Cleveland Indian is nothing but a Sambo with red face. Let's be real. The Cleveland Indian shit that, yeah. I think whenever I see that, I fucking cringe. I see it. Just like when I see that cereal box, because I know my history, because I know about Sambo, because I know what it was used for, I still see Sambo. Okay? So, but I see, like I said, I keep repeating myself. Anyway, look. Xavier Woods is actually right. Sometimes us as black people, we need to slow down and do some research before we start jumping to conclusions. But you also cannot delete historical context. You can't delete it. It happened. It's there. It's so bad that even when WB plays those old cartoons, you remember, I know you remember Xavier Woods, everybody remembers, then now they put this little disclaimer like, okay, we're not going to delete this out of the cartoon. To delete it is to deny the fact that this existed. Xavier, you are smart enough to understand that this existed. And when older people see it, they're going to react a certain way to it, regardless of what the context is now. Because the context is now is different from what it was before. Unfortunately, but whatever. But I'm so glad that Xavier Woods did booty-os. Okay, I got a t-shirt upstairs. Right now I'm in my army gear. I'm in my army gear right now because I did a thing today, so I can make up for the fact that I'm going to wrestle this Saturday. I did a split drill because I'm wrestling this Saturday in Delaware. But where would I leave off? Oh, Xavier Woods, I am so glad that you, Big E Langston, and Kofi Kingston all got together and that magic happened. Because like I said, I was really upset when the church group thing happened. I was very upset about it. And then when it evolved from do it for the day, I ain't going to do it, to fucking New Day rocks and everybody screaming sucks. And then you guys turn heel and my little brother, who is a little black boy, got excited and was happy about it. He got so excited. He called me up. He's like, New Day turn bad guys, John. And I've been telling him New Day would probably be better as bad guys first and then switch over to being good guys, because it would be funny and be hilarious. And it would work better than being overly positive black guys, because WWE fans don't want that shit, unfortunately. I didn't care. I would have supported him regardless, because I always would have supported him, because I was a big Kofi Kingston fan. I really felt like he should have been champion at some point. And at this point, I really hope that WWE books freaking the New Day to win Money in the Bank. I wish to God that New Day wins Money in the Bank. Please, God. If there's a God, please win Money in the Bank. There's going to be two cases. So I'm hoping that please, that would be the best story ever, okay? You could have them fight for it. Eventually, it got to break up. Have them fight for it. Have them beef over it. Have them even hot potato it in front of somebody who was the champion. Like, oh yeah, you don't know who's going to cash in on you, but it's going to happen. Anyway, I'm so glad that he wrote this. I'm so glad somebody said something. I am positive. I love Xavier Woods now even more than I ever did. Okay, I knew he was a smart guy. I follow him on Instagram. I always was a fan when he was in freaking TNA. When he was a Apollo. Okay, it was Austin Creed. He's Apollo Creed. Anyway, look, I'm really happy. This is a 20-minute freaking video. This is the longest video I've ever had. But yes, guys, Alex Thomas was wrong. Xavier Woods is right, right? But in some spaces, Xavier Woods need to understand that when some people see that book, when I see that box a bootios when they see that t-shirt, when they see that cereal. Some people are going to see something. Like I said, my mom hates the fact that I call her Aunt Jemima because she still remembers Sambo Aunt Jemima. She remembers slave Aunt Jemima. She remembers that Aunt Jemima, but the Aunt Jemima now that we have, she looks different. I say she kind of looks like my foster mother. So my mom hates it. So I understand why. So I stopped calling her that. It's a historical thing. So Xavier Woods is right. People need to understand, but also he needs to also understand historical context. Some people see black guys on a cereal box and, you know. But also, like I said, little kids see it, and it's going to normalize it for the little kids. And that's fucking tremendous. Thank the New Day. Thank you, WWE, for allowing New Day to exist. I hope the WWE expands and allow black wrestlers to be different characters and not just these, I'm big and black and strong, I'm going to dance, I'm foreign, I'm a stereotype. Yeah, I hope that happens. But New Day is pretty much one of the first in a very, very long time besides The Rock. So I hope, please, 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 please. Anyway, all right, guys, sorry. I hope I didn't take up too much of your time. But that was freaking great of Xavier Woods.